Hello.
Hello, good evening, sir.
Yeah, good evening. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good. Thank you so much, sir, for your time.
Okay, thank you for joining. Okay. Okay, so what's your problem?
Yeah, sir, I'm sharing my screen.
Yeah, no problem.
So this is my study area. I basically dissertized.
Yes. And you want to add the buffer 5000 meter?
Yeah, I added the buffer only. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So, see, right now I'm using it to identify the NDVI, but I need this shapefile for other calculations also. So how I can add it to my asset?
Okay, so in this time, if you want, you can download this shapefile and then import the shapefile in asset. Or if you want, you can simply accept this shapefile in your asset tab. Okay, so in this time, you can simply go to the below, or if possible, simply you can send me the code link. I write the code, then send you the back. It also better. Okay, so first of all, you can simply click get link button and send me the code link. Okay, then I show you the process. You can easily add this shapefile in your asset, or if you want, you can download it further. You can easily use it in ArcMap or QGIS software, then you can also use it, no problem. Okay, so let me check and share my screen. So now I can stop your screen and then I will open it and show you that process. Sure. Okay, so now can you see my screen?
Yes, sir. So can we please record this session?
Okay, I'll set it. Okay, so this is your code. Okay, so now suppose this buffering region you want to export as a shapefile in your asset tab, or if you want, you can also download it and use it other geospatial software such as ArcMap or QGIS software. You can easily use. So for this time, you just simply write the code export table. Okay. In this time, when I use the to drive function, it mainly stored it in my Google Drive. Okay. In this time, suppose you want to export this table in your asset. Okay. So that's why you can easily get it in your asset, this boundary shape file. So for that, you can simply use that to okay. So now when I use the function export table to asset, then this shape file is stored in my asset tab. So from here further, I can easily use it for other analysis. So let's go, just I simply put all of those things. So first of all, I just make the curly bracket start and curly bracket end. So first of all, collection. Collection mainly in this time, first of all, this AOI, okay. Suppose, okay, first of all, I simply print this AOI and check. It is a feature or feature collection. Suppose I simply print this AOI and click the run. So now we can get about the information. Is it a feature or feature collection? It working. Okay, in this time we can get the polygon 3724 vertex. Okay, so now I need to convert it as a feature collection, because here you can see my first argument is the collection. So for this region, I just simply take a variable, suppose col, and use our ee dot feature collection. Okay, and further I simply call this variable aoi and paste here. Okay, so now further I check, suppose print col and check. Okay, so now again, so I can get the feature collection. Okay, so in this time I need the collection, so that's why I convert it as a feature collection. So now I further write the code in here one by one. So in this time, collection mainly it's stored in here. I simply copy and paste. Description, I put the description, suppose river. I put this name so that I can find out. Asset ID not need, I simply remove that and also remove that. So now further click to the run. So now our task time will be running, and when I click on this run button, it takes some time, and then it is stored in my asset tab name river in. So you can see okay, so river in, I simply click to run. And you can see it is stored in my asset ID. Okay, you can see in this time here, you can see it's my folder name. In this time, I select EER Bijanur 690 asset. Okay, so I select it and river in and run. So now it will be running and stored in my asset tab. So you can see it working, start the working. Okay, so it's a one process to store the asset. Store it mainly your shape file or any feature collection in your asset tab. We can store it, but another way is that if you want, you can simply download it. So for that, you can easily use the ArcMap or QGIS software. For that, just simply use the function export table to drive, and further just simply put all of those arguments one by one. So here you can see the this collection. I make the dictionary. I already make the collection, feature collection I already make. So first of all, you can see collection mainly it's my collection. I put the value col. I put the description, suppose I put the description is that mainly suppose I put the river in folder. I put the folder, suppose I put any name, suppose I put the name is that file name, simply remove that. I need to mention about the file format. I put the file format shapefile, SSV shapefile. I did not remove that. Okay. So now it download and stored it in my Google Drive. So from the Google Drive, I can easily get this result. Open in my ArcMap or QGIS software, I can easily get the result. So in this time here, you can see it also loaded our task tab also running. In this time, so I think, so I use the same name, suppose I use here this so that I can easily find out, differentiate it. In this time I just simply run this file name, and I can easily, it is stored in my Google Drive. From here I can easily download, okay, so this file, okay, run it. So now it is stored in my Google Drive as a shape file. So further, I can easily use it, ArcMap software, QGIS software, and you can see it already done asset tab. So in this time, I simply refresh and find out this name. Okay, so my file name is the river in. So I try to find out it river in where. River in, okay, click on here. So from here I can easily input this file in other code or other analysis or other things. We can easily do it. Just click to the import, then this file will be imported. You can see this is your river file shape file, and from the Google Drive we can easily download the shape file. Further we can easily use it in ArcMap or QGIS software. Okay,
yes sir.
Okay.
Sir, one more query is how we can use Landsat data for biomass calculation.
Okay, so in this time for the biomass calculation for Landsat data, there are a lot of ways. Suppose, okay, so I show you some sample algorithm. Suppose Landsat.
Sir, last time you taught me how to calculate biomass using